Y'all know it's on, right?
Y'all, we back
with another one.
Number two. It's lit. Cause y'all thought we wasn't gonna be back, but we are. Mm-hmm. And it's motherfucking lit. So I am Lex.
And I am B.
And this is the Girls Room Podcast,
where we not only talk about the streets, but we leave you all with a little bit of love.
Go. I don't know how to do that. I be feeling like I'm gonna start throwing up games.
Not gonna throw a game.
So no, for real. All
right.
How so, you doing?
I'm making it.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm making it. I done had a rough. I feel like this weekend was kind of mentally rough, and today was okay, but unfortunately things happen, so I'm here. But yeah, you know, I'm just grateful to be here and grateful for what I have.
Always. That's good.
Mm-hmm. How are you?
Girl, tired. I don't know why. I think because the baby kept I was watching my niece. Mm-hmm. The baby kept me up. She would not go to sleep Saturday night. Like,
oh, yeah, it's the weekend, honey.
But she went to sleep easy Friday night. She was mad that I woke her up on Friday night. But Saturday night, every time, like, I don't know. I guess she just wanted to be on me because every time I put her down, she woke up.
Oh, she's one of those type of babies. That's so cute, though.
Put you down. That's so cute. No, it's not. Mm-hmm. Not when you want to go to sleep. And she woke up like 2-3 times in the middle of the night.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah.
That's a baby for you.
Yeah, baby, baby. But yeah, I'm tired. But I had a good day today.
Y'all had a good day today.
Really? No, for real. Because it's Monday and I'm already knowing.
It's storming over here. It's storming outside. I don't know if y'all can hear
it. I hope y'all can't hear that.
It's a nice rainy Monday evening.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm excited for the weekend. We got a whole weekend
coming up too, so we'll let y'all know about that later.
Yeah.
Y'all just got to see it.
What's
by the time this is posted, it's gonna be already unpacked.
Yeah.
Dang. Okay. Well, we might put a little snippet at the
just
end
a little
of this for y'all
some,
to see.
Some, you know, we finna
back outside, boys.
Hey.
Okay. Let's just say that.
We about to have fun though, for real. I'm excited about the weekend. I feel like I need this weekend.
Me too. It's been a long time coming. And it's,
I ain't been nowhere since me and my cousin took that random trip. And before then, I hadn't been nowhere in a while. Ever since I moved out, I be acting, I don't know. It's like, I be so busy and I just don't be going nowhere.
I want to say the last place I went was the same state, but last year. Yeah. At the end of last year.
I think so, too, right?
That was the last place I been.
I can't even tell you the last place I been. Baby, the last place I been before this, the last trip I just went on was.
I ain't been
in
no plane.
Baby, the last place I went was New Orleans.
I know you fucking lying.
I swear to God.
I know you lying.
That's crazy.
That was 2021.
Yeah, but no, that was 2022. Because I was locked in. Like, last year, I was locked in real bad. Like, I was making money, okay?
Yeah,
I was trying to save, stack my bread.
She had
so.
Moving on up, moving on up. That's what
it
was giving.
Yeah, no, for sure. I had to stack my bread, so I wasn't outside at all last year. For real, for real. I was running it up,
that's
man.
That's what you do. You got goals to meet.
Yeah. You got to sacrifice them.
I did three travel experiences last year.
Did you?
I went to New Orleans, then I went on a cruise with my family to the Bahamas,
mm-hmm.
and then I went to that other state. We're gonna let y'all know. I don't know why I want to keep it a secret
so
bad,
but we about to have fun.
Y'all
okay?
Know what another outside state is besides Georgia, so we
that everybody goes to
know. Y'all already
it's all right though, because we finna have fun. That's all that matter. Oh, so what's in your rotation?
Where have I been listening to? Oh, you already know what I've been listening to.
What, the same song?
No, I actually, okay,
Friday, Victoria Monet dropped her actual album.
Yes, I listened to Bray. Why I listened to that album this morning. I listened to it for the first time this morning before I got to work. That's probably why I felt so good this morning. I was like, oh, I like this.
I listened to that album. Oh, I like it. I know about all the words every song. Yes,
I like her album, Victoria Monet. Her thing.
Musical composition in her.
Yeah.
All her songs, honestly. She has literally
live it was no skips. I didn't pianos, skip nothing.
Everything, like, you hear the actual music. Yeah, and I love it. And then she had the Earth, Wind, and Fire on that Lord.
Girl, I ain't skip no song. Vibe, honey. I don't know. This morning, I was just like, let me listen to Victoria Monet album because I ain't heard it.
Y'all need to stream that Jaguar was too,
girl,
for sure. And I listened to Travis Scott's album.
Let me go.
And that came out like a week ago.
You know what been in my rotation? You know what been in my rotation?
Don't say nothing lame.
Nothing lame.
What?
I'm just on my Future vibes right now.
She toxic.
I've been on my Future and Lil Baby vibes so bad. I've been listening to anything Future, and I've been listening to. Specifically, I've been listening to one Lil Baby album real bad. What album is it? Hold on, let me go. I'm gonna tell. What is going on with my
bro?
Oh, it's the weather messing up my stuff right now.
People probably think we total opposites. We actually listen to the same type of music.
We do.
But I feel like you be liking.
I like nigga music.
She like nigga music more. I like nigga music too, but I'm more of a.
My turn. I've been on my turn real bad. I don't know why. Like, I think I feel like cause I don't know. I do like nigga music.
She like Atlanta nigga music.
I love Atlanta nigga music.
And I be liking Dumb Kennedy.
Baby, Larry let me June tell you something.
And Currency and shit.
I'll be right at a Future concert. Front and center.
And I like my R&B vibes for sure.
I love R&B though.
Oh, we didn't bring them out.
We was getting there.
I thought we were going to bring them out first.
Bring them out in second. Bring them out in our EO rotation is first, and then bring them out. Work?
No, bring them out is first.
Bring them out, bring them out. I'm looking at, oh, I passed it.
What's in our rotation? But she fucking up the rotation.
Right, I know I'm definitely fucking up the rotation. I went straight to check-in. I didn't even think, I wasn't even looking at bring them out.
We were supposed to sip on something. And
sorry,
y'all.
Bring
them
out. Bring them out. Okay. Bring them out. Bring them out. Bring them out. It's hard to yell when you.
Okay, keep going.
Okay, but not for real.
Okay.
Bring them out. Bring them out.
Bringing them out today.
We got something new for y'all.
The drink of the day is some wine. I believe this is a wine. Yeah, this is a wine. I got this from Trader Joe's. I think you can only find this at Trader Joe's. Don't quote me on that. You might not be able to just find it at Trader Joe's. You might be able to find it at Kroger or Publix.
Walgreens. I feel like if you got it from Trader Joe's, you probably can't find it nowhere else. But Trader Joe's.
No, for sure. Okay, this is a wine. They got different flavors, but I love grapefruit. And honestly, this is the only one they had on the shelf, love. I think they got like a mango or something else, but anyway.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they
We need to do a series.
We need to do a series. Next episode, I might have a different flavor for y'all. We might be on this one for a minute. But yeah, the name of it is Seiko. I think I'm saying it right. It's a grapefruit pumpalini. I don't even know what a pumpalini is. I ain't even
girl,
gonna lie.
You know.
But it gives me Paloma vibes. Because you know Paloma is grapefruit too. So it gives me Paloma vibes. So we're gonna pour this up real quick.
If you don't know where Trader Joe's is, find out real soon. Because I love Trader Joe's. Okay? Love it. It's the ice for me. She be with her different ice cubes. It's so cute. It's so cute.
I'm an ice cube girl.
I wish I was an ice cube girly. I just don't have the energy. I'm literally a tomboy at heart. I'm girly when I, like, at times where it be like, what you got going on? Me.
What you got going on? And this is, I think, yeah, it's 8%.
Oh, it's good.
Ain't it?
Yeah. Y'all know this is my favorite part. This my favorite part.
I'm
stuck
calling it bit out of the box.
Out of the box.
I don't even know why I'm
making
this
noise. Cause ain't that they don't do that out of the box? I think they do that.
I caught on the out of the box late. You remember? I didn't have cable.
Out of the Box was on cable?
Yeah, I thought
it was on cable. It was on cable. I only used to watch Out of the Box at my cousin Selena's house.
I only watched it in Anissa's house.
Damn. Now we was the no cable friends. Right. In my opinion.
Shake it up.
Let's get it, yeah.
Topic. Let's see what we're talking about today.
I'm so excited. I love this part. You go first. I went first last time.
What a good topic. Deal breakers.
Oh, deal breakers.
I love that one. Ooh. I feel like I got a lot of deal breakers. Damn.
That made me sound like a strict dater.
She real strict. She on this motherfucking scaring hoes.
Right. I be scaring the hoes for sure. I be like, oh, I'm like that.
She be scaring the hoes, y'all. That shit is funny as hell.
Because if your house smell like dirty water, bye. I'm out of here.
Oh my God. Okay. That's funny. Okay.
Don't invite me to your house if it's not funny.
Don't invite me to your house if you are not clean. Like,
don't do that.
That's disgusting.
I think my deal breaker, I'm going to just do deal breakers in relationships because I feel like, well, no.
What's your deal breakers in friendships too?
In friendships? Yeah. Like dating stages too. But that one a little. That's
look at that in my cup.
And that motherfucker swimming.
I'm talking about them, man. My shit a pool.
We need to cover it up. Y'all.
It's all right.
The Gannett.
Literally.
That be pissing me off.
No, for sure.
Y'all, it's a Gannett in her.
It's a Gannett in my drink. And it done drowned.
You trying to swim.
Made my shit a pool and drowned.
Oh, boy, I'm about to die.
Anywho.
Okay.
Anyways, deal breakers. Let's see. What's a deal breaker?
Okay. I'm going to let y'all know off top and don't be. What if? I hate that what if shit. If you cheat on me, I'm gone. Like, I don't do
deal
that.
Deal breaker.
I don't do that. I'm sorry.
You know what's a deal breaker for me? When it comes to, like, you know how niggas be like, oh, she just crazy. That right there, I'm gone.
as soon as
it's a girl doing some crazy shit and the nigga say she just crazy, no, you're doing something to make her crazy, I'm out. And that's all you got to say. All you got to say is she just crazy. I'm going to be like, all right.
I mean, she might have a little crazy in her, but it's a reason why she's not just off the top. Like,
she's not just crazy for no reason.
Crazy
she's crazy
you
because you're making
her do that.
I seen a post, right? It was a post of this girl in the car throwing a temper tantrum because her ex wouldn't take her back.
Yes.
Did you see the quoted tweet?
No.
They niggas was like, my problem is we probably would have been laid up that same night. And I said, that's why them girls be crazy, bro.
Exactly.
What's a deal breaker like off rip though? Like, what's a deal breaker
that would
make you like not even like, go into a date with a nigga, like into really dating a
nigga. So I need a scenario. Like, if he just asking me on a date, like we ain't even went to the date,
or
yet,
like if he want to mess, like if he want to talk, if he want to like really pursue you, what's a deal breaker in the first stage
that made me be like, oh nah,
yeah, like I'm cool, yeah.
I'm such an open minded person. Let me think.
Right.
Because I feel like somebody has came at me and I'm like, oh nah.
But I feel like my deal breakers are not concrete. Like, I feel like
it
just depends on the
based.
Situation, right? It just depends on the situation.
I mean,
like,
if you give me some type of sign where it's just like, I'm an attentional dater. So, if I feel like you just, if I done heard about you before.
Yeah.
Or if I kind of, okay, I knew this was a red flag before and I don't even know why I just went for it. A dude did ask me on a date before and I went on a date with him, but his friend basically kind of got us to talk to each other because he was just like, oh, my homeboy want to talk to you, blah, blah, blah. A little put on type shit.
I don't
but
like
the
on.
Friend that did that.
He liked you?
No. He just was one of them niggas that be in the streets, and I knew he hang with niggas that be in the streets. Oh,
yeah, birds of a feather. So,
all flock together. They all a big-ass crew that do that shit.
Yeah.
So, it's just like, I don't even know why I even went. I was just being stupid as hell.
Do I truly believe that?
I do. Because they done all proved me right. I done tried. Like, I tried in that situation. I'm just like, this nigga is for the streets. He want to be in the streets. He want to take me on a date, but then what? You not dating.
One of my deal breakers is, if your, this about to be so funny. If your ex ugly, I can't mess with you. Like, if I do my background check on you and your ex ugly, now I'm finna be like, am I ugly?
No, for sure.
And then I'm gonna be like, well, I know I'm not ugly, so why he wanna talk to me?
Right. Well, maybe he like,
but I'm not finna be your first cute bitch.
But maybe he like, damn, like, maybe I can get a bad bitch. You know,
no, because maybe I can get a, you know how, you know how this, you know how I'm a, no, I'm gonna tell you how that's gonna go. If this nigga got it in his head, they're like, maybe I can't get a bad bitch, and then he come over here trying to get me right, yeah, and then I'm doing bad bitch shit. He gonna be in his feelings. His chest is going to be hurting.
Maybe he like that. Maybe
he gonna be like, oh my, like as soon as I go outside looking like a bad bitch, then he gonna be like, where you going?
He might not. He might not. I mean, a lot of niggas do that.
But we can't. We can't go for a mic.
Well, how you gonna know if you don't try?
We can't go for a mic. All
right. I'm too nice. That don't mean slide in my DMs either.
What's your friend? Ooh. What's one of your friend deal breakers?
I don't like when people slide in my DMs like they know me.
Like a person that never met you before?
Yeah, nigga, slide in my DM like, hey, what you doing? Who are you?
No, that's wild.
Get the fuck away from me.
That's wild.
I don't know you. No.
Nobody's ever done that to me.
Yeah, no, yes. They done
did. I'm glad people don't slide in my DM with the weird stuff.
And I be like, do I look like that type? Like, I done had the worst DM slides. And I'm just like, y'all just be trying me.
I don't be having, my DMs don't be.
Husbands.
I will say, now, okay. Friend deal breaker. What's a friend deal breaker?
Girl competition.
Nah, that's real. At the first sign of girl competition, you gotta go.
Right. That, oh, and I hate it when somebody that's supposed to be a friend, they'll call you and just be like, they just start rambling about their issues. They don't say, how your day going?
What you doing?
Or even say, are you in the space to even
listen
to me and give me the advice I need? You just start talking. I'd be like, God damn. Hey, how you doing?
I think one of my friend deal breakers is if you think I'm going to be a yes friend. Because I'm not. And if you feel some type of way about me not being a yes friend, like, okay, well, bye.
If you aren't open to hearing what I got to say, or you're not a receptive person, then we ain't going to work. Leave me alone.
Yeah.
Another, if you take everything to heart, too, I hate that. I hate that.
Stop with that cry baby stuff.
We be joking like a motherfucker. I think like,
everything is we be joning. And we be thing, talking about.
One thing we gonna do is talk shit. Okay.
Why she talk to this nigga? Damn.
If a girl would've been like, yeah, no, because why are you talking about my man? I was talking to him and I really liked him. Girl, shut up.
First of all, if my friends tell me that the nigga I was talking to not hit on that, I'm probably gonna laugh because she probably comfortable telling me that because we both already know that nigga ain't nothing.
That was a funny time.
Like, yeah.
That was a funny that time. Anywho.
Yeah.
I like that one. That was a good one. Don't cheat on me. I don't double back. And that's the thing, too. Like, if you break that deal, if it's a deal breaker, I'm not going to try to
go back and try to, yeah, nah, it did.
Like, even the first date thing, I'm not reconsidering after that. I already saw what I needed to see.
I'm just a real, when I'm done, though.
Yeah.
Like, once I'm done, I will literally be looking at you crazy, like, what you want from me? Mm-hmm. Like, if you try to come back, I'm be like, I thought we was off that. Ooh. Like, no, baby, you was off that. He wasn't.
Right. I think another deal breaker. It's be something about me and folks' houses. When people don't, like, wash their dishes. Or I hate when I go over somebody's house and they got dishes and, like, they just don't dirty, care about or, like, yeah, just messy. Or they expect you to do it. I done been,
no, y'all. People, don't you be going to people's house and they expect you to wash their dishes?
If I'm dating them. If I'm dating them. That's like, I done dated somebody and I swear, this nigga would purposely not pick something up because he knew it would bother me. And I was going to pick it. Y'all.
Baby, that house would have been dirty and I would have never stepped foot back in it.
I hate people.
I don't play like that.
Yes, people be doing that. I don't like, play like I'm that. I'm going to have to let my husband know. I like to clean up. Well, I don't like to clean
baby,
up.
Baby, I yell.
I like to keep a clean house, but I would cuss your ass out.
I yell. Quick. I yell. If you get dirty, I'll be like, I talk to people like they my kids. Why is this like this?
Nah, for sure. I go upstairs with the plate. Why the plate look like this? And why is it sitting in the
Why you got this in here?
Right.
Like, that's disgusting.
And if you sitting on the bed, I'm going to sit on the bed with you and walk out.
Yeah, I yell. I think that, girl, please.
I yell at my dogs like they kids.
If people house dirty, like, okay, say if it's my friend and they house dirty, that's just going to make me not want to keep going over there.
Oh, no. One of my best friends, you know who I'm talking about. I ain't even going to call you out because you already know it. Even when I go over her house, she be like, don't go in my room. And what I do? I go in her room because I know that shit going to look a mess. I open up the door. She be like, why did you go in there? Because I knew it was going to look like this.
But it gotta
clean up your fucking room.
It got to be dirty to the point where I don't even have no space to sit down.
I can't see the flow. It be closed everywhere. And she be like, don't go in my room. I be like, that's why I'm about to go in your room. Just so I can talk shit about how dirty this shit is. Clean this shit up. She be mad as fuck at me.
That's funny as hell.
See, and that type of friend, like, I'm going in and I'm talking shit. Now, if you sit up there and cry, like, I'm going to your house and never come back.
Please don't. Please. I ain't gonna care. I sensitivity is kind of a deal breaker for me because yeah. I'm okay. At one point in time, I was not sensitive to people's feelings. I am now though because I went to therapy and my therapist told me that was me.
I feel like my friend deal breakers are more solid.
Yeah,
because I know what type of friends I want to have. I like fun friends.
Right.
Like, I like friends that know how to laugh about stuff. And, you know.
That sad friend all the time. I'll be like, oh, I can't be around.
Girl, like, you being. No.
I can't be
please.
Around.
Please.
Friends.
I like girl. Friends that I could, like, go anywhere with and have fun.
Yeah.
No matter where we go. We go to a freaking museum or a party. You know what I'm saying? Or, you know what I'm saying? Anywhere.
That might be a deal breaker for me. Like, a friend that feel like you got to be either on the scene or in niggas' faces. Oh, my gosh. I hate going out with a group of girls where their main goal is to get niggas.
Yeah, that's one of my friend deal breakers now. I feel
I'm not hanging out with you no more.
Yeah.
I'm not. And if you your friends, if y'all going somewhere, don't invite me because I'm not coming.
Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Like, the friends that be like, the niggas out, I'm be like, right. Nobody and I'm cares. Be like,
well, I'm a bitch. We the bitches that's going to be in because right. I'm not going.
I don't care about that. Like, I don't like that. And my friend, like, I don't know. I just don't care about that. Like, I'm not going out. Nothing I do is for the male gays. Okay?
Exactly. Like,
I don't care about the niggas.
The way I dress, the makeup, the hair, that all shit that. Is for my me. Vibe is for me.
That's I'm not doing that to impress I appreciate like, pretty girls exactly. telling me that I look nice mm-hmm. rather than a dude because like, who cares what you think?
We don't do that to impress like, people. We just do that because we love ourselves.
Yeah. And you want to look good. You right. feel good you, when you look good.
Yeah.
And if we present you with that vibe, then hey, I feel blessed enough to be even able to give you that vibe. Yes, go ahead. Yeah. Enjoy my vibe. Yeah. But that don't mean push up.
I don't like a friend. I think one of my deal breakers when it comes to friends is if every time we have a conversation, it's always about niggas.
Yeah, because I'm hang up on you.
Because there's no substance. Like, where is the substance, babe? What are you doing with your life? Your life? What goals? You want to do? Like,
okay, what you want to be a wife name? And a mom?
Is
okay.
your mama okay?
Right. I get it. We all want to be wives. We all want to be moms. Some people don't, but a lot of us do. But it's more to life. Like, do you want a business? How do you expect to grow financially, emotionally, physically, mentally? Like, something.
Let's talk about something else.
Right. Some substance, please. Yeah, friends with no substance.
Friends with substance. Yeah.
Can't be, what she do? Over with. Sorry, y'all, that's inside.
Y'all, that, okay, I will explain it. It was so funny, though. My friend, I ain't gonna tell y'all what we talking about, but my friend, she gonna watch this, and she gonna know exactly what we talking about.
She said,
I'm dead. Okay, let me pick.
What can you do? Girl, now she finna fly the things off the back.
Okay, let's see.
Be like Salt Bay or something. Ooh, I like this one.
I feel like it's something I want to talk about.
Self-awareness. I like this one.
That's a good one.
Self-awareness is so important.
It's very important. I had to learn that. I really had to. I feel like in these last like 3 years of my life, since I was like 26, yeah, I feel like I grew a lot more self-awareness, and I'm more cognizant of the things I do, the things I say, how I give off my energy to people. Yeah. Like, I'm still me regardless, but I'm not as, yeah, I'm way more considerate. If y'all know me, y'all know I had a foul mouth.
She used to be mean. Y'all.
I was very mean. I was a mean girl.
B used to be mean.
I was a very, like,
bro, I've been friends with her since I was in the second grade. I remember sometimes it used to be like, you can't even say nothing to her because she will snap on you. You'd be
like, I feel like I still have my moments for sure. I feel like that just comes with life. Like, yeah. Or as you grow more self-awareness, it's gonna dim down over time, and yeah. I do still have my moments. I'm still working on myself, and it's okay, but as long as I'm able to acknowledge it now and see where it needs to be fixed at, then that's still growth within itself.
But self-awareness is important, and I feel like a lot of people lack self-awareness. I feel like I started getting my self-awareness when I went to therapy the first time. Like, y'all, I am a real advocate for therapy. I want to be a therapist. I'm in school right now to get my license. So I'm real big on mental health and just, you know, just figuring things out, you know. And to make sure that I'm self-aware, I reflect a lot. Like, I think a lot about the situations that I'm in. I always think about my part in the situation. Like, I never want to just blame the other person and be like, you did this. Like, I'm always thinking like, okay, Alexis, what did you do? What can you do better? You know, like, I always try to think about that type of stuff because I am very, I just care about the impression that I leave on people. And I care about how I treat people. Like, I'm not the type of person, it would bother me if I treated somebody poorly and just that was just it, you
yeah,
know.
I feel that. I feel like I done had actions in the past where I probably made someone feel smaller than what they was, or
I've definitely used to
just make them feel really icky and bad, and I don't like that, because I wouldn't, for one, I wouldn't want somebody to make me feel that way. And for two, like, I just don't want to put that energy out to people. Like, that's not good energy. Energy transfers.
I feel like at one point in my life, I just switched from I don't care how I act to I care how I act, because karma is real. And you putting what the energy that you putting out is going to come back to your life. And you don't control, or you never know when it's going to come back. And it's not going to come back in the same form that you put it out. So if bad stuff is happening to you, you need to take stock of how you've been treating people and what you do. You know, like, I feel like that's very important to just be able to not control, but just put out good energy so you can continue to receive good energy. Because honestly, I done been through so much in my life, and bad energy is not something that you want to just be. I hate bad energy. Like, it just makes, I promise you, like, when bad stuff is happening, it just be like,
I have literally sat in some bad stuff and be like, what did I do to somebody? Yeah. Or what did I do to other people to make this happen to me right now? Like, and then, so after having those type of thoughts, I'm like, bro, just put out good energy. Just be a good person. Like,
you just never know how much you can help somebody. Maybe they already had bad energy. Maybe it was meant for you to cross their path so they can have some better energy. I be thinking about that stuff too.
Yeah.
And then I also realized, like, even though I was probably angry inside, that don't mean I need to make other people angry. Like, I done been through some stuff in my life. I done been bullied. I had a lot of anger built up inside. I didn't grow up having all the nice things and stuff. So we struggled. So, yeah. But one thing I did realize is that my family always had love. So it's just like, if I grew up with a lot of love, I don't have to throw all of my bad moments or the anger that I got built up from the other things that I've been through at other people. Maybe since I didn't have other things, but I had love. Maybe I should focus more on spreading that love than putting my anger out. Like, I can handle that. And I think I was like 26, 25, 26 and whatever, when I was actually like living on my own. Like, I didn't have a boyfriend and all that. I didn't have no dogs, nothing. I spent a lot of time by myself. Yeah. So that's when I grew more self-awareness. Mm-hmm. And I felt like I need to grow more. Like, I really need to focus on the good. And good things that happen to me, I can put out more good energy to the world, and I can help other people too.
Yeah, that's so real. Yeah. But I do feel like people need to learn how to be more self-aware, because you're hurt. Like, when you're not being self-aware, you're hurting people and you're not even paying attention to what you're doing. Mm-hmm. Like, you're not even really, like, you just don't. It's like you don't care. Right. And you might care, but it's like, you have to think about your actions in order to really care.
Other people, and it's going to affect you in the long run. It really is.
Yeah.
And you're going to lose relationships off that too. Like, really good relationships that you could really value.
Like, even if I'm being terrible, like, even if I'm not being the best person to somebody, like, I have, like, literally, legit, I have been not the best person to somebody, but, like, just reflected and apologized to them. Like, even if they probably weren't even thinking about the stuff that I apologized to them for, but when I'm thinking about it, I'm like, Alexis, that's not nice. Like, you wouldn't like, my mama told me to treat people like you want to be treated, and I really stand on that. Like, I wouldn't, if I am thinking about it and I'm like, I wouldn't be okay with somebody doing that to me, I try not to do it.
Mm-hmm. Good. Self-awareness is real.
All right. Until next time. What's some trending topics, babe? Oh, y'all seen that man? That man went to he went to that jail.
That man went to that jail for all of 15 minutes.
Yeah.
I knew he wasn't gonna stay long. I knew it with that little demonic picture.
That's crazy.
And what was up with the other lady?
Girl, it's her with that.
She's like a little menace.
Bro, I was like, what is going on?
She like that emoji, the purple devil emoji with the horns.
Yes.
That's her. Oh my god.
Ain't nothing been going on social media for real, except for ratchet stuff. Right. Jacquees now, y'all. Jacquees and Ella Mai.
Ella Mai done said hey to him for the first time
in years. Ella Mai petty.
Was mad about that.
She petty. First of all, Ella Mai girl, you should have let Jacquees keep his remix up, because Jacquees remixed everybody's stuff, and you were the only one that felt some type of way about it.
And his remixes be hits, honestly.
I think Jacquees' remix of Trippin' was good.
It was. Honestly, he remixed a lot when he was coming up. Like, that's what his thing. And it was working for him.
Queemix, girl. Let him do his
Queemix. They put you on the limo. That limo sauce.
Amen. And I think she should have did it. I feel like if Jacquees remixed your thing and you was feeling like, I feel like she should have put him on a remix.
That would have been nice. Because Ella Mai is a really good artist. And them two, don't do that.
What?
I saw your face.
I like Ella Mai.
I like Ella Mai.
Honestly.
That would have been cute. If they I think so too.
I think, but she petty. She petty. Jacquees said.
Him for years is wild.
Jacquees said she still got him blocked on social media.
That's insane.
Well, not you block him because he did a queen mix. Girl, I ain't bless you. Nacho did that. Ella Mae is funny.
That's hilarious.
That's why. Are you like this girl? Everybody let knows. Him do his remix.
Okay, he is not the king of R&B, honey.
Nah, you see the interview. But when he did the interview, he's talking about
that. You was tripping when you said that. You know you was tripping with that.
Nah.
He was like, yeah, I know I was tripping.
But y'all know that boy was trolling.
He was trolling like a motherfucker.
Yeah, he was trolling when he said he was the king of R&B. But he
could be
the
king of remixes, though.
He's definitely. That boy I think he's definitely the king of remixes.
That's the queen mix.
Because Jacquees, one thing he going to do is remix a song, baby.
That was funny.
But LMA. LMA,
get over it.
LMA, girl, let it go.
Money. He got his money. Y'all got hits.
Let it go, sister. Let it go. That's funny. Let's see what our question of the day is. Ooh, 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 ooh. It's time to get into the streets, y'all. We didn't even pick which one we was going to do before we just started doing this. Okay, let's do it. Hold on. Let's just... No, pick a number between, oh dang, where it go? Hold on. Pick a number between 1 and 5. Don't pick one.
You better be glad I don't remember the question. I don't remember the question order. Between 1 and 5 and don't pick.
One.
So between 2 and 5.
2 and 5.
Dang, I was going to pick the middle number, but they even.
Ha ha.
5 minus 2 is 3.
You picked the whack one. Oh, no, you didn't. Yes, you did.
Whack stuff on here?
Not sure. You picked the whack one. No, you said. No, you picked the one that you said we was going to do when we have a guest.
Oh.
So you got to pick.
It's only whack because she ain't got no good story.
I sure don't.
Dang, hater.
We can talk about it and let you tell your story.
Child,
you
too.
All right.
I don't even remember what that was either. Yes.
Do you believe that everyone has a soulmate?
I don't know. I feel like everybody has a soulmate, but can you have multiple soulmates?
I think you can have multiple soulmates.
Yeah, because like, what if they? I don't know how to say it, but like, what if they tap into different parts of your soul?
Girl, talk about it. Let's talk about it.
You got deep up here.
I feel like you can have multiple soulmates. I definitely feel like you can.
Yeah. Do you feel like you've met some soulmates?
I feel like I've met a couple. And I feel like I'm gonna meet a couple more.
I feel like
maybe not. I don't know.
I don't know because I feel like at a point in time maybe I felt like that could have been one of my soulmates, but then what they did to me, I cannot respect them ever again in my life. So. Do I have to look past that part and still see the connection that we had, regardless of what they did?
I don't know. I think so, do you?
But then it's just like, you wouldn't do that to me if we were soulmates.
You know what's crazy? The people who I feel like might have been my soulmates are people that I messed up stuff with.
Ooh, now she fumbled. Ooh, the guy that got away.
I definitely fumbled.
Have I ever fumbled? I feel like I ain't never fumbled.
Really? That's good, sis, because baby.
I mean, maybe one, but we were young as hell.
But that don't mean you ain't fumble. It's still, a fumble is a fumble.
I don't know. I felt like at a point in time, maybe I had fumbled, but then again, I felt like our lifestyles probably wouldn't have matched.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, when I look back at my fumble, I feel like now when I look back, I don't feel like it was a fumble. But at that time, it was a fumble. Like, it was okay. A fumble.
I can see that. Okay.
Now when I think back about it, I'm like,
damn, I might have fumbled that. I can see that for me.
Yeah.
Maybe one.
When I look back on it, I feel like I connected with that person in a way that I might not have ever connected with anybody else.
That's a good one.
But it's like a different, I feel like you can have friends on mates too, and I feel like I've had mine.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I have mine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I feel like I have mine. I definitely had. Well, I don't even want to speak of it in the past tense because I still have her.
Yeah,
I just don't physically have her anymore. Yeah,
I feel.
But
as far as soulmates. Okay.
I mean, I feel like I will.
Don't feel like you've had any. You've met any.
I think after a while, I just be like, they wasn't for me. Like, I feel like I look back and I can feel that. Both our minds.
I see that about you, though. Yeah. I know that you think about it like that.
I be thinking of stuff like that. Like,
but I think about it. I don't know. I feel like
what I'm thinking too deep.
What made me, I think so too. I think what made me think about that person being, okay, when I think of soulmate, okay, when I think of soulmate, I don't feel like, I don't feel, okay. I feel like most people think of soulmate and just be like, oh, your soulmate is like the person who you're supposed to be with forever. Mm-hmm. I don't feel like that. I feel like your soulmate is someone that you have. Y'all, I believe in reincarnation and I believe that we come out, like I believe we live different lives. Mm-hmm. So I feel like a soulmate is someone that has been in your past life, someone that you truly connected with in one of your past lives too, or multiple past lives. It might be the same soul. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's what I feel about a soulmate. So when I came across the first person who I felt like was a soulmate for me, it was a really different experience. Like, it was so different, bro. Yeah. When I say different, I mean, like, I never felt like that about nobody. Like, even my friends know. Like, the people who, people going to be watching this, my friends are going to be watching this, and they're going to know exactly who I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Like, so that, bro, that made me feel like they, bro, we know
what she's talking about.
Bro, we know that was a soulmate. Like, real deal. Like, they going to know exactly who I'm talking about because I never felt like that about anybody before them.
Maybe I'm thinking too hard. Maybe I'm being too strict.
But I feel like you also have to think about, just because, like, say if it's a person that you connected with in a past life, y'all might be in a different.
That's the thing. I'm thinking about my connections, and I'd be like, I connected with them. Nah.
She, because once she not, once she ain't connected that no more, is, yeah, she like, just not even think about it no more. And it disgusts her.
Every, literally, like. That, I think like that's why I don't double back to people, because once like I'm off you, I'm so off you, I can't even remember.
But you know what? I wouldn't ever mess with him again though.
But you still like remember the connection. The connection was great though. Like I was in a whole relationship with somebody that I felt like I think when I'm off somebody, I tap out of them so bad that I forget. Stuff how that happened between, yeah,
I'm not, I forget. I'm a good very stuff. I'm a person, I'm very I reminisce,
yeah, and I feel like I don't like, because once I'm done with somebody, I try to push them out so bad,
yeah,
I be pushing them till a year or two later I can't even remember their middle name. Literally, that be me. That's why sometimes, baby, she be bringing people up, I'll be like, who is that?
That's,
I think that's just how my recovery works for me sometimes, and that might be bad. Honestly, I think that's bad.
But you know what? What I realized about soulmates, y'all, I'm about to be real vulnerable real quick. I have a anxious attachment style, so when it comes to like people who give off soulmate vibes, I be scared. I ain't gonna care. I be scared. I be like, what minute? It's scary. I feel like the soulmate connection kind of scares me a little bit, to be honest.
Okay.
Because it's so intense. Like, it's like, is. Oh my God. Like, where did this person come from? Who sent you?
Right.
That's how I be feeling.
Okay. So now that we're talking about it more.
Okay. Okay.
I feel like I might have had like two in my past, maybe one currently. Mm-hmm. I feel like one of them was like, we didn't give each other ourselves enough time to grow into something that could have been more than what it was. Okay. It was a relationship, but I feel like it was like one of them mediocre relationships. It could have been way more. Mm-hmm. And then the other one, yeah. I definitely think we had our course, but toxic stuff happened. And it was dead.
Hey, man. That's how, I feel like everybody does have a soulmate. But I feel like everybody might not meet their soulmate in their lifetime.
And that sucks. I hate that.
Me too.
Because,
like, I feel like even if you married, that might not be your soulmate.
Right.
Yeah. That might have just been the safe option.
Never mind. Because I be thinking sometimes, like, about my mom, how she's by herself. Mm-hmm. Like, and she don't talk to me. Like, she got her kids. It be us and her. Yeah. And she be okay with it. But I be like, dang, do you want a date? But I think she be okay with it.
She probably is.
But then again, I think she already met her soulmate. I think my brother's, my oldest brother's dad was her soulmate, but he passed away before we was born.
Just think, I think about it like this. Lauren London. True. Nipsey was her soulmate, yeah. I feel like. Mm-hmm. So, like, and I've heard her say, like, she was grateful to experience that type of love in his lifetime.
Right.
I feel like you're lucky to get the type of love that you get from a soulmate.
Right. Maybe it runs this course, and maybe they are
reincarnated. Yeah, I feel like
you'll meet them in the next lifetime.
Yeah,
I believe in that. I believe in next lifetimes.
Me too.
And I believe that if you have those, you have the same connections in every lifetime. It's just in different forms.
Yep, I think so too.
And you might not realize that you're not gonna never. That's the thing. You're never gonna pinpoint it. But you're gonna have that feeling. But you can't be like, oh, this happened in this last lifetime with this person, and that's what you are now. It's just like you feel that feeling where it's like you don't know where it's coming from or where it's just been.
Hella familiar.
Yes. It's like it's just out so of this familiar. World type.
Yes,
yeah,
I'm telling you. Bro. It's just so familiar. You just be like, oh my God, I feel like me and this person just is, why are we like that? Mm-hmm. Like, that's crazy.
That's
like being her. If in another lifetime, I might meet her somewhere else and know that I've met her before and know that, you get what I'm saying? Like, know that, like, this person is supposed to be my friend.
Right. But they're not going to,
but it won't, it's just not going to be the same.
It's not going to be the same. Yeah. Like, what if, like, in the next lifetime, I have a friend, it's this girl that's just like, we cool as hell. And it's just like, I don't know why we so cool, but that shit lit. But we never get past just being cool. And it's just like, but what if that was you in this place? Like, we like dead ass sisters. Like, we think this, well, we think differently, but we have so much in common. It's crazy as hell.
For real.
Like, seriously. People really think we sisters because our connection is so strong.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
Like, legit. Like, you would think, I feel like you would think the way we are, you would think we trying to be like each other.
No,
but we literally just like this. The same shit.
And it's not girl competition.
And I love it. I love it. Like, literally, I could be like, I will come over here and she would have something. And I'd be like, I was about to buy that.
Right. One day we might have the same thing. I'm going to be like, oh, literally. Well, we should got the same shit on today.
Oh, well, we just twinning, whatever. Right.
Yeah.
But yeah, I do believe that everybody, I believe everybody has soulmates, but I don't feel like everybody meets all of them or any of them, maybe. You never know.
Love is such a beautiful thing.
It is. I love love.
I love it too.
I want y'all to tell us what y'all think about soulmates.
Right.
What y'all think? Because I feel like it's also, y'all, I'm real into this type of stuff. So.
Oh, the universe.
Yeah. I'm a real spiritual universe type of person. Like, y'all, I'm really that. So, like, some connections are like, baby, it's different connections. You can have your twin flame, you can have your karmic connection, you can have your soulmate.
We got a whole episode on this.
Girl,
yeah. Valentine's episode.
No, for real, yeah. Since we both have said that we feel like we have met soulmates, what do you feel like the person. What do you feel like about the connection that made it
a soulmate?
I felt three things.
Okay.
Full transparency, vulnerability, and I want to say like a understanding connection type thing. Like, we could fully be ourselves around each other and we could be vulnerable in every aspect of our lives. Like, it wasn't even just on love. It was on our life goals or our struggles, things that we really, really, really struggle with that didn't nobody else know. Like,
yeah.
I think that's what made me think about my recent soulmate. Like,
yeah.
It done got deep, like real deep. And we done pulled stuff out of each other that we didn't even know each other were dealing with, type thing. Like, he pulled something out of me that I didn't realize in myself, and vice versa, and we were able to help each other with it and see each other for who we really are without, you know how sometimes they'll fully know you but you'll kind of be sugarcoating it a little bit. Like,
I done been boohoo crying on my knees like about life before.
Yeah.
And they done picked me back up and they didn't judge me for nothing.
That's cute.
Like, they literally know everything I done bad, I did good, I did things that been done to me. And like, I don't know, it didn't change nothing. It just brought us closer together.
That's cute. Yeah. I think mine was just the connection. Mm-hmm. Like, I just never had been connected to somebody like that. Like, and I don't know what it, honestly, I can't even really pinpoint what it was about the connection. I just never, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I just never experienced like
a love like that.
Yeah. Like, it was just like, whoa.
Natasha Benefield.
Never had a love like this. It was just really different. Like, yeah, it was really different. It was also very, what am I trying to say? Rough.
It was rough.
Yeah.
Because you did say y'all hung on, so y'all couldn't hang on no more. Yeah.
It was a really rough ride, I will say that. So yeah, I know, and it was very unexpected. Like when he came to me, like initially, I was like,
I'm on your radar.
Now you're trying to talk to me.
What? It caught me off guard so bad because he wasn't on mine. And I didn't think I was on his. Like, I thought we was just real, like, different people. So like,
those,
yeah,
the ones though, them unexpected.
Yes,
ones,
I was like, this is crazy. But I gave it a chance. Like, at first I was a little
skeptical.
Yeah, like I was like, what do you want from me?
Right.
But baby, I gave it a chance. Ooh, and it was really, I was like, oh my god.
Y'all fall deep.
Yeah. Yeah. It's not even just that one though. It's a recent one too. Yeah. It's the recent one too.
Yeah.
So yeah, I believe soulmates are real.
I think they're real too.
Yeah. Okay. Well, our discussion got deep, but
yeah, this is a good one.
I think it was good today. So, did you get your? Do you have your with love? Because we want to leave you guys with love. We want to leave you guys with love. I have mine. So my love message today is start believing that you are deserving and watch what happens.
Mm-hmm. I gotta do my
Yes.
Okay, so y'all know how we was talking about self-awareness and how people be trying to not renege it, what I'm trying to say. They don't be receptive to you becoming a better person or your transformation. After learning your self-awareness. So mine is, be a good person, but don't waste your time trying to prove it to anyone.
Yes. Yes. You don't have to prove yourself.
You don't. If you know you're a good person and you feel good about yourself, just all
the baby, matters. The only person that need to know you a good person is you and God. Okay? He know your heart.
Yep.
All right.
And with that being said,
see you guys later. We wrapping up our episode. Love you guys.
Oh, you know we need to start doing
what?
Peace up.
A-Town down.